Working as an assistant vice president, credit portfolio senior analyst with Citibank. It's been almost 2 years I've been in US, and I started my journey when I was in high school in Lucknow, which was like a long time back. I was awarded as a valedictorian in all five subjects that I took in my high school. I got good marks, and then after that, I came for my bachelor's in economics from the University of Delhi. I learned a lot from my professors. Alongside, I pursued actuarial science, a lot of internships in the field of international business, strategic management, with companies like Deloitte, UNESCO, Ministry of External Affairs, Ministry of Home Affairs, all of that back in India. Luckily, I was able to find my passion very early on. So that's what I knew I wanted to do, analytics. A major thing that was included, like that was a part of, was I wrote a research paper when I was interning with Indian Institute of Technology, which Delhi, which was awarded the best paper award when it was presented at an international conference. And that's when I knew I wanted to do analytics. Honestly, I always knew I wanted to come to US, but then I still searched for courses that were there in analytics in India. You would be like surprised to know there are not a lot that were there, and they were definitely longer period courses which required experience. So in the end, I tried applying. I got in like 4 out of 5 colleges that I applied to. Didn't get into my target school, but then that's fine. It happens. I graduated from my master's in business analytics from Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute, that's upstate New York, in 2018. I worked with the New York State Department of Health as a data analyst for 9 months, and recently switched to Citi. Have been working with the company for a while now. It's been great, but the thing is that every story has challenges. Mine did too. So the major challenge is like application, GRE, TOEFL. That's the normal challenges you would know, and that's something that you would actually be able to like discuss it with everyone who's applied abroad. There are things that I have personally experienced and I want to share, which are not really publicly stated anywhere. For example, when I got into the school, first of all, first challenge was GRE. I was good in quant, as Deepa mentioned earlier. Verbal was bad. And Naveen sir was the one who helped me push on that. And I'm so thankful for that. I gave GRE twice. I got a 312, which was like a benchmark score for my university. But I was like, okay, move on. And then, yeah, the major challenge I faced when I was accepted to universities, I was trying to come here, and I was looking for accommodation. So Indian parents, they're really, really protective about how girls stay here and how do you like present yourself there, and things like that. Very, very like tiny things, like how would you get food? Do you know how to cook food? Don't know how to cook food? So a big thing is that every university here has an Indian Student Association that is ready to help you come here, and they can help you like know what's going on, and they can help you in accommodation, food, and everything. So that was a great thing that I experienced when I was coming here. I reached out to them and they helped me settle down here. Second thing, Indian food is available everywhere, so don't even think about like that's not there. There are streets, I would say, there are Indian streets. You would actually feel that it's like a street you're roaming around in Delhi. You would get street food, trust me. You get Golgappe here, so the next thing that I want to talk about is security of women. So in terms of that, US, I would say, is much, much better than India, but still there are countries that are better in women's security. For example, the European countries, and I would say Canada as well. But that particularly, I believe, comes with capitalism. So this country is a capitalist country, and we need to accept that. So yeah, moving forward, Talking about the scholarship, someone mentioned that there are a lot of scholarships. Yes, there are a lot of scholarships, one thing. There are different kinds of scholarships that we have here. One is the normal core scholarship. Second is the teaching assistant scholarship. Third is the research assistant scholarship. And fourth is a working on campus. So all these things cover a lot of your expenses. So yes, it's not expensive to come here. But you have to make worth it while you are like here, and you have to be involved in so much stuff. One thing I like, so my finances, I will discuss about my finances. Actually, my scholarship summed up to around 70 to 75% when I calculated in the end. In the first semester, my course was 2 semesters. In the first semester, I received a teaching assistantship, which waived my tuition fee entirely and gave me a stipend to tutor the students for the entire semester. Second one, I wasn't able to get a TA, but I had a 40% scholarship for my university course. So it summed up like a 75% tuition scholarship, which is like a lot. If you calculate in US dollars, it's a lot. So yes, there are things available. I also have found out something that even companies here, like Microsoft, Google, they sponsor students to study. They are the ones who push students and they give company scholarships to them. So even check out that, whoever is like planning and targeting to come here. The next thing is about the job markets. Yes, there is literally no biasness in the job market. Women have been getting empowered so much here that there are specific conferences that just have women in business and technology that give a push, and they like discuss about the job market and their networking and all kinds of things. So there's one is on my top list that I want to attend. It's called the Grasshopper Conference. It happens every year, and it's literally a way to get into the best companies that you can even think of. Microsoft, Google, Apple, whatever is your target. You go there, you attend like a 3-day seminar conference, and in the end, I would say you get a job until you come back. So so the job market is tough. It's tough, I would not lie about that. But I would say, isn't it tough in India? It's like that competitive, everything's there. The only way you can solve all these things, all the challenges that you've had, that I've discussed, is whatever I have done, I can tell you that I've just networked. Try to reach out to as many people as you can. I believe people are there to help you. You just need to ask for help. And you should know how to ask for help. So once you know that, you should be good. Yeah. And if you have any questions, I'm here to take. Thank you.